What is up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. I feel like this makeup was very requested after I posted my like full beat glam look. I said I wanted to do something a little bit more natural and everyday, and I just love, and I feel like I'm not the only one in this, like Madison Beer's makeup at the moment. That glowy look, kind of really like more blush focus, really like, yeah, glowy, glam, blushy, like healthy almost look. I just think it's perfect for people that want a slightly more natural makeup look. I feel like I use still quite a lot of products in this, and disclaimer now, a lot of them are Charlotte Tilbury, because I feel like after I watched her Vogue makeup tutorial, you can tell she's quite the Charlotte Tilbury girl when it comes to products. It's not sponsored, this video is not sponsored by Charlotte Tilbury. I just thought I'd give like a heads up, but I do ask throughout the video, and I'm gonna say it now, leave some Charlotte Tilbury dupes in the comments if you know down below, because I know Charlotte Tilbury can be a bit pricey for some people. So let's help each other out. Let's find some dupes so we can like recreate this look maybe for slightly less. But I'm obsessed with this look. You can see super glowy, natural, feel like perfect for this time of year, as well as like summer and stuff. Sometimes in the winter, I want that more like natural flushed makeup look, and she is just so gorgeous. So I really wanted to recreate a picture that I saw of her. I think it's her current Instagram picture, and the one that you'll have seen in the thumbnail. I just love, love, love that makeup look. I feel like anyone can achieve this, and it's gonna look beautiful on anybody. So I really hope you guys love it. Again, slightly more natural. Similar products that I use all of the time, but I feel like now I've like found my cult favorites. I just kind of like find different ways to use them. And today we're going down the more like natural, glowy, glam route. So I really hope you love it. Rambling done, let's jump straight into this. Madison Beer glowy, glam, everyday vibes makeup tutorial. Right, I'm hoping the sun is gonna stay on my side. We've got some natural light still, but it's not like beaming in my face. So the picture I'm using for reference, I don't know if I will have said this in the intro or not, but it is this one. It's her current, can you see that? It's her current Instagram display picture. She just looks so gorgeous. Her skin just looks so fresh and dewy. It's very like minimal and simple on the eyes. Why do I feel like I look like a little mole? Right now, I've got four clips in. Normally I would have like two, but I feel like I needed it all out of my face because I've got a bit of a bouncy fringe going on. So we're gonna go ahead and do the skin first. And just for skin, I'm actually just gonna use the Laura Mercier Perfect Cream Multitasking Moisturizer. Oh wait, actually, before we do that, I am gonna go in with the Anastasia Brow Freeze to brush up my brows. I feel like this works better when it's just on direct skin, because then I can like clean away up here. I always forget to do that. And then when I go in with foundation, it's really textured like above my brow where products like this still are. So if you're finding that, go in with this product first. Even if you don't do your actual brows first, just style them up first if you use products like this, the Refi Brow Sculpt, like that kind of thing. Because then you can go in with a wipe just to clean away the edges. And I want to use a product like this because Madison Beer's brows are really like big and fluffy. She's just posted a new picture of her at the Spider-Man premiere. Her makeup there and just her in general, stunning. Not that she doesn't look stunning like all of the time anyway, but literally gorgeous. So yeah, because my brows are naturally quite small, I want to give the illusion I've got nice big feathery brows. So a product like this that just pushes all the your brow hairs up is perfect, and also like keeps them in place. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. Not too much, like, don't want them to look like super, super laminated, you know, but just feathery. And then, like I said, go in with the wipe above. Right, so now I'll go in the moisturizer. This is the Laura Mercier Perfect Cream. This is a little bit pricey, but it's so good. Like, I think I've used this ages ago. Rinsed the jar. Like, I had to get another one. It's just super, super hydrating on the skin. And then also, as it dries, leaves a little bit of a tack. So I feel like it's intended to be not just a daily moisturizer, but also primer. It does say multitasking moisturizer. So that's kind of what I'm using it for. So, and just like let it sit on the skin. And again, guys, like I said, I think at the beginning of this intro, there is a bit of Charlotte Tilbury used in this, but I feel like ever since I watched her Vogue makeup tutorial, and I've seen that on TikTok as well, that girl that does all the PR things for people, PR moves, and she's like, the PR moves I would do for Madison Beer, she should be the face of Charlotte Tilbury. I'm pretty sure she sold out the Pinkgasm wand, like, it's because of her. But I also thought this would be a great opportunity for you guys to leave, if you guys have found any, leave your Charlotte Tilbury dupes in the comment section down below, because I know Charlotte Tilbury can be pricey. I do think, as a brand, it is worth the price. I'm very fortunate to have been gifted a lot of Charlotte Tilbury in my time, but I do purchase it myself. I'm obsessed with it. I go through those Flawless Finish powders like no tomorrow. Like, they are amazing. So maybe like treat yourself to some Charlotte Tilbury this Christmas. Honestly, it's a brand that I have grown to understand the hype and be obsessed with. And I've been obsessed with these, the Flawless Filter. Again, it's not really like a primer. It is just to go like under your foundation. I was wearing it as a foundation just on its own because I think it's gorgeous on its own. But I'm just gonna wear this under foundation. I feel like this is kind of an unnecessary step, especially if you want this to be a bit more of a everyday makeup look. I'm going for more like natural glowy glam, but that doesn't necessarily mean like less products, if you know what I mean. But if you want to do this on a less product, if you want to recreate this look with less products, you can probably skip this step, but I have grown to love it and I think it makes such a difference. I use the shades 4.5 and 5.5 just to go underneath the foundation that I'm going to use. You can see they're like quite drastically different, but when I mix them together, they be working. I had a lot of questions about this brush on my last makeup video. It just says Rachel on it. Oh wait, Smashbox. It's from Smashbox. But yeah, I'm trying to do my best when I do these makeup videos to mention the brushes that I use, because you guys always ask me, and then by the time you guys ask me and the video's been up and I'm like replying to your comments from my sofa, I can't remember the brush. So I'm trying to do them like as I use them. So this one is from Smashbox. It doesn't have like a number or a name. And it also says Rachel. But yeah, I'm just gonna pop this on. So I feel like this and the moisturizer is basically gonna be my primer. And as you can see, we're obviously doing the skin first. In that particular picture, her makeup doesn't look super like sharp or clean cut or anything like that. But you can see, like, that looks gorgeous on its own. Can you see why I thought it was a foundation? And it just leaves such a gorgeous glow on the skin. And now, you guys might hate me for this, but I thought this would maybe get you excited for what's to come. I know someone that works at Charlotte Tilbury, okay? And I said to her when I saw this advertised, I need to try that. Can you please tell me when it's dropping? And I'm pretty sure it's dropping very soon, so you won't need to wait long. But it is the Charlotte Tilbury Beautiful Skin Foundation. Can you see why when I heard that name, I needed to try it? I applied this yesterday just to try it out. And I normally feel like when things come in tubes like this, I feel like it's going to be really sheer. This is definitely buildable, but like medium buildable. So you get coverage from this, but an immediate glow. I'm using the shade 7 Neutral for reference, you guys. It's so... you only need like a little bit, like one pump each side. And I am gonna go in with the brush first, as per usual. This is the Morphe M446, and just press that into the skin. You can see the color is perfect, literally perfect. So like I said, guys, this is 7N. If I can, I will ask my friend at Charlotte Tilbury the official launch date of this, so you guys can mark your calendars, because I think this is going to be my new favorite foundation. Not only does it feel so lightweight, but like look at that glow, and the color I think is perfect. I'm definitely more of a neutral girl rather than cool or warm toned, but I'm just like obsessed. So lightweight on the skin, but the most beautiful coverage, glowy coverage. I feel this is very Madison Beer, like Madison Beer skin vibes. I can't picture her wearing anything like Estee Lauder double wear or anything like that. Wow. And like, I feel like I don't even need to like go over with a sponge to make sure it's all, you know, into the skin, because it just sits so like gorgeously and glowy on the skin. But I'm gonna pause there because I am gonna go ahead and do one eye, and then I'll be back to show you to do the other eye. I only do that because I just wanna, I'm trying a new technique. Oh, actually, do I just wanna do the full skin first? Because when I look at that picture, she's not really used like concealer to like sculpt anything out. Maybe I'll just keep going with the skin. Okay, we'll keep going with the skin. So again, nothing changes here, except I am gonna be using two shades. The Holly Boone Soft Focus Airbrush Concealer. Again, my go-to, my whole skin routine is literally just Holly Boone and Charlotte Tilbury. They are my hot right now brands for face. So if you still haven't tried anything from either of them, this is your sign to do it. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply the shade 2.5, like all over. Like I said, she doesn't really look super lifted here. Maybe it's because her face is just, it's got that natural lift anyway. So I'm just gonna buff that in. I might take that onto my eye to prime it a little bit as well. Like, it's just so beautiful. Like, this is just such a gorgeous skin routine. I think the word satin to describe skin is the way I want my skin to look. I want my skin, I don't want it to look like super, super dewy or like wet or anything like that. It's like satin, you know? So when things are described as satin, I'm like, yum. That foundation, satin, like 100%, like a medium buildable satin lightweight finish. It is gorgeous. I'm just gonna go ahead and conceal, but then I am actually gonna take one more shade of this. This is in the shade 1W and just 1-1, because she does have quite a bright under eye going on. So I kind of use that beginning shade to just get rid of any bags or anything, and then this one's really gonna be the brightener under the eye. And I did actually see someone say like I should really be, or like I should try using a brush to buff out my under eye concealer. So I just forgot to do that this time, but maybe I'll try that next time. But this is what the skin is looking like so far. I'm gonna go in with cream contour. Now I know Makeup Revolution do a dupe of these. This is the Magical Way Liquid Concealer. And I know she's got one of those light, Charlotte Tilbury has like one of those light ones in the contour shade, which I'm trying to get my hands on because it looks insane. Any dupes for those? I know I just told you a Revolution one of the concealer, but of the magic wands, drop them in the comment section down below because they're literally out of stock, I'm pretty sure. But there must be dupes somewhere, like something similar at least. But yeah, this is just like a twisty up concealer. Just gonna do some dots all around. Like so. This is in the shade 12. And this brush is from Morphe. It is their E63. It's like a really gorgeous angled brush. Perfect for just like pressing on that contour angle. Just look how beautifully that just like blends out. See what I mean about Charlotte Tilbury? Like, I know it's a little bit pricey, but if you're gonna treat yourself at any point, it's either Christmas, birthday, or, you know, any day that you want, really. But if you need an excuse for yourself, now is the time. Or, like, put it on your Christmas list. Like, a Charlotte Tilbury gift voucher if you don't trust anyone to buy the actual makeup for you. I'm pretty sure she, I hope she does gift vouchers. Or, like, a Selfridges gift voucher, because I know she's sold in there. We're just going to blend that out. There is definitely more of, like, a blush focus in this makeup look. She is a blush girl, Madison Beer. So this is just meant to be like a really natural bronzing to give like some shape and structure to the face, the Madison Beer bone structure that we all desperately want. So that's that pretty much blended out seamlessly, if I do say so myself. I'm now gonna go ahead and powder. Now, if you just like a light dusting of powder, a translucent powder is amazing. I do think that, and I know I use them in every makeup tutorial, but they are just incredible. The flawless, the airbrush flawless powders from Charlotte Tilbury. It takes my makeup from one level to another. And it works so well on my skin and looks so amazing. Again, another product if you've not tried. This is not sponsored by Charlotte Tilbury, by the way. I have just discovered a newfound love for her makeup products, and I think they're insane and really worth the hype. If anyone knows any dupes for these, let me know, because I am so obsessed with them, but they are such a pricey, like, repurchase product. I'm happy to do it because I know it's amazing, but if there was a dupe, let me know. I am more than happy to try it out. But again, I'm using the little brush from the Morphe Aerial collection. I'm taking the shade 1 under my eyes, and I kind of press it, and then once it's pressed, I kind of go like circular motions and bath. Like, look at that. It is flawless, as the name states. And I feel like when you're using like a lot of Charlotte Tilbury powders, products together, it does just look so beautiful together. I'm gonna make sure to powder my eye as well, just so that's set for when I go in with eyeshadow. But you can see, again, I'm just gonna take a little bit of shade 1 here. And then I go in with a bigger brush. This is, again, one of the Morphe Aerial ones. And I take shade 2, like, look, hit pan. I'm gonna have to go into my drawer and see if I've anticipated a run out so I can replenish myself. And I kind of just like buff this everywhere. This is just basically to like set my whole face. Like so. And I'm now just gonna go ahead and do my brows and one eye off camera. For brows, nothing new. I said this in my last makeup tutorial. Guys, I don't know how to do my brows anymore. I've gone back to the shade 3.5 because I think 4.5 in the precise of my brow pencil was where I was going wrong. It was almost like a little bit too dark. I might go over the ends in it, I'm not sure. But I just want like a feathery brow look, nothing new. I wish I had naturally full brows like Madison Beer. I am gonna get my brows tinted though, before Christmas. I've had them done before by this girl, literally amazing. And I think tinting is gonna make a big difference for me. But yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and fill in my brows and do one eye off camera. And then I'll be back to show you how I did that eye. I'm just gonna test out a little technique quickly that I've seen that I think is the vibes I want to go for, and then we can finish with the skin and the lips and all of that good stuff. But the skin so far, I am obsessed. Okay, so these are the eyes. You can see it's actually really, really simple. So I'm actually just gonna go in with, oh shit, did I do that eye already? Hang on. Did I already do that eye? Am I actually okay? Let me just like buff that out with concealer. Sorry about that. I just got completely distracted. Anyway, well, you can also see I've done my brows. Better than before, I think. I definitely think 3.5 is still my shade. I did a little bit of 4.5, but I feel confident with 3.5. So right, I'm gonna go in with the bronzer that I'm using on my face, which is literally just the Mineralized Skin Finish from MAC in Dark. I'm literally using like all Morphe and Dull Beauty brushes on my face. And I'm just gonna buff this into the crease and kind of like drag it up to give that more like lifted look. And then again, don't forget to sort of take it slightly down the bridge of the nose as well. That's literally all that we're doing in the crease on that eye. And then on a slightly smaller brush, again, from Dull, I'm gonna be using the By Mario palette. It's literally all matte neutral shades. It's so good. I'm literally just gonna tap into this shade once. Like, I really don't want a huge amount of pigment or like color with this. This is just to define the crease slightly. Like so. And again, when I'm buffing it out, kind of making sure to drag it out, giving it that like lifted eye shape like she has. But from the picture, she barely has anything in her crease, so this is like a great eye look. Again, if you just want something quick and easy, but put together. And then I'm gonna take this brush from the Morphe Aerial kit and take this shade here. Again, you could use your face powder. I think I used my face powder in my previous video. But basically, you just press this on the inner part of the eye. It's just gonna really brighten everything up. You can go back in with other brushes as well. You could even go in with a shimmer if you want. Whatever you want as just like your easy, like everyday lid color. And then I'm gonna take an angled brush. This is from Benefit. And it's like a firm angled brush. It's quite small as well. I'm gonna take this shade here. It's like a cool medium brown. And what we're gonna do is start actually from underneath the eye. I'm trying to like make sure I get this in the camera. Like the bottom of the eye. Just gonna create the baseline for us like that. And then essentially connect that line to our upper lash line. So we're going on the top and the bottom. Like so, and that's just gonna really help to snatch and lift. And then just take this across the top, like so. And then what I'm gonna do is actually highlight my inner corner now, just using the matte white shade from that Mario palette. Just press that in there, like so. Then go back in with the small angled brush, the same color. And she, as you can see, kind of tapers in her inner corner. Or if she doesn't and her eyes naturally look like that, we're essentially just mimicking that. So this brush is really good to just press that in and like take it up into the inner corner. Like so. So it's really subtle, but I think it makes a big difference actually when it comes to like your eye shape and the way that your eyes look. And this is literally my favorite brush from the Morphe Aerial eye brushes. I'm just gonna take it, no product really on it, and just buff that underneath shadow that we did, just so it's kind of like diffused a little bit, you know. And now I'm gonna go ahead and do mascara and lashes. And for lashes, I'll insert a picture of them here because I've used them, and if I lift them up, they'll fall off. They're from Ardell, and I feel like I'm really late to the trend of pre-cut sort of clump cluster lashes and just placing them on to kind of give a more like lash extension, more natural look. So like I said, let me just go ahead and put mascara on first. I'll zoom you in. Oh, okay, I can't zoom you in a little bit more. Maybe I'll crop it in a little bit more. So essentially, I take the number one, the number two, and the number four from the lashes. I'll put the picture on the screen again. So the one, two, and four. You can use all of them if you want, but I feel like this was enough for me. And then I just put a little bit of lash glue on like a surface. And I start with the outermost lash, dunk it in the glue, pick it up on your lashes, tweezers, and just place them on, you know, where you want them to be. And again, same with the next one. These are just so natural, and I quite like being able to place it because sometimes it's quite hard to find like a really flexible lash band, looks the way that you want it to, like the lash style, etc. I'm sure one will come soon. But then the final one, I think this kind of mimics the appearance of like lash extensions and just kind of a more natural looking lashes for sure. So the trick with these is to kind of place them where you want to place them and like just go and like finish the rest of your makeup, let it dry, because then you want to clump and like lift, do you know what I mean? So that's basically the eyes done. So easy, everyday, like simple, but like lifted. I really like how subtle that inner part is. I don't do that often. And I think it actually makes such a difference. So let's move on back to the face, and then we can kind of like perfect the eyes a little bit later and do the lip. And I feel like this part of the face that we're on now is where all the glowy dewiness, the Madison Beer vibes really come to life. So like I said, with this makeup, it's very just like focus on the blush. So I'm gonna go back in with the dark mineralized skin finish from MAC and just lightly bronze up the skin, not focusing too much on the contour. I just want to lightly bronze, really. And again, this is a MAC brush, 129. I think Morphe do a dupe of this, but I love this brush. It really does just give a really just soft application to the skin. Again, I am going to go in with a bit of a contour kit though for the nose, because we all know about Madison Beer's nose, all right? It is something made by the gods. Just a cool tone eyeshadow powder. This is an Anastasia Beverly Hills contour kit. And this brush from Dole Beauty is insane. It is the... Does it have a number on it? Doesn't have a number on it, but it's like a flat tapered, really small brush. You just want to connect sort of back up into the eyeshadow and just take it down. Like so. And then I'm going to just go across here. You see? And then really at the top of the nose. Like that sort of effect. Sponge is the next important thing when it comes to nose contour, because you basically just want to dab over the top of that so it's not too harsh. And I feel like highlight placement is going to be the key to really like lift up the nose. But because this is more of like a blushy, glowy look, I know this is out of stock everywhere, guys. Please leave dupes of this down below if you have one, or like sign up to be notified when it comes back in stock, because it's honestly amazing. And I know that she loves this. Although I actually did see she did an Instagram live or like a TikTok live or something where she was answering questions, and she also really loves NARS Orgasm, the liquid blush. Pretty sure that's still in stock, but she said she loved that too. And I saw all the comments underneath being like, please, can she not sell out this product as well? So this and NARS Orgasm are like very similar. It's that rose gold dewy vibe. She is a very like rose goldy blush kind of gal. So I'm going to go in with the Pink Gasm Beauty Light Wand. Use my little Rhodial buffing brush to buff this out. Like, it's gorgeous. And you could just leave it there if you want like a just highlight, like that's enough blush for you. But in that picture, it is very blushy. Like, she's got rosy cheeks. So I'm almost going to use that as like a blush primer base. And I'm going to go in with the Dole Beauty blush in the shade Let's Get Wavy. Looks like this. I'm going to take this Morphe Aerial brush. It's so light and fluffy on the cheeks. And he actually uses this for blush application, and really just lightly press, because this is pink, okay? But I don't want it, I want to be able to customize it. I don't want to go in too strong and have to blend it out. So I'm tapping a lot of the product off and just kind of like twirl that on the top. I could probably go in a bit more like that. This is gorgeous. Looks kind of like intimidating in the pan. Like, it's a really bright pink, but it just adds such a beautiful like flush of color to the cheeks. Obsessed. And obviously that glow underneath is coming through. But we're not stopping there. It wouldn't be a Madison Beer inspired makeup tutorial if I didn't use something of hers, and I've been loving this as well. She looks like she uses a lot more of like the liquids and cream products when it comes to her skin. And this is the Morphe Madison Beer Shimmer Highlighter in Fairy Tears. It is pink undertoned. I'm just gonna go ahead and like squirt a little bit on the back of my hand. This is another dull brush. And just kind of dab and just stipple it onto the skin. Like, it's so pretty. And I'm actually really loving like a more pinky based highlighter, because it kind of acts like blush at the same time. I really, really love it. And the skin just looks so fresh and glowy. She has a lot of like freckles going on here. I don't know if they're real or like faux freckles. So if you really wanted to just like recreate that specific look, feel free to go ahead and add them on. But the eyes, I'm gonna go ahead and clump and like make sure they're really locked in, like the lashes, and like lift them up slightly as well. Because one thing about Madison Beer's eyes, they are very like lifted, like so. See, I feel like, oh, I understand now why people use those lashes, okay? I was able to really like customize the placement of them, and I love that. I am actually gonna take a little bit of eyeliner. £10 to the person that guesses the eyeliner I'm gonna use. NARS Mambo, most gorgeous brown. I'm just gonna tight line my eyes real quick. Just to really sort of emphasize the cat eye. And just, I really have been noticing such a difference of the way that my makeup looks when I tight line, like in pictures. It just fills in like any sort of gaps, you know? So now I am actually just gonna take a bit of powder highlighter. This is NARS. Why does it say orgasm? Because that is not NARS orgasm. Okay, anyway, it's just like a little powder shimmery highlighter. I will try and find it down below for you guys. But this is just to highlight my nose. So what I'm gonna do is take a little brush and really place it like on the highest point to like give the illusion of more of like a tip. And then just on my finger, or you can use the brush, I guess. Just place it down the middle to really give the illusion of like a narrower nose, the narrow Madison Beer like button nose that we all, well, I say we all, I say on behalf of myself, like really aspire to have. And I feel like, not that she's famous for her nose, but it is just the most perfect button nose ever. Like so. You could totally go ahead and like powder highlight your face if you want more of like an intense highlight. But I'm kind of like preferring a bit more of just like the glow, you know, rather than like an actual beaming highlight. Now for lips, I'm gonna go ahead and line my lips and kind of fill them in slightly with the Morphe Sweet Tea lip liner. Okay, the lips are lined. And from the picture of her, she really doesn't look like, I don't know if you can see, she's wearing like really anything at all. And you know, I said earlier that she gives me like NARS orgasm vibes, like the rose gold, like it's very her. NARS had this little lip, well, I'm sure they probably have a full size. This is just a mini version of their Afterglow lip balm in the shade Orgasm. So I was like, this is perfect. So let me try this out. I had to line my lips because I feel like it just gives a little bit more like shape to them. And she does have a very like pouty lip. The on the top. That's gorgeous. So that's my first time trying it. I was gonna put like a liquid lipstick underneath, but I was like, no, like her lips look kind of just like juicy and like balmy. We could just leave it there. They look quite like light though. I've got this MAC lipstick. It's called Blossom Friend. Can't get my words out then. Blossom Friend, and it's a cream sheen lipstick. So I might just go ahead and pop this in the middle. To just lighten it slightly. Yeah. Oh my God, isn't that so pretty? I love that, and it feels so like soft. Now I've like got that picture back up again. She has like a little bit more like blush on her nose. So let me like blushify my nose slightly, but I feel like, oh, probably quite a crucial step. I'm gonna go in with Fix Plus just to like freshen everything up. Whew. And then if you feel like that's enough, but I'd kind of go in with like, this is the Revolution, Creator Revolution Makeup Fixing Spray. Basically, after you've dewified yourself with the Fix Plus, this is what's gonna really just like lock that in place. So once this is dried, I'm gonna go ahead and apply this, and then that is the finished look. So this is the finished makeup. I love this so much. I feel like this has been a very like go-to routine. I think it looks amazing in pictures. It's very Madison Beer vibes, very glowy, like everyday natural vibes. I know like there's a lot of products, so maybe like in terms of applying all of those products every day is not like the most convenient for everyone, but take what you want from it in order to sort of like recreate this look if you do sort of want to wear this more every day. But this is like my favorite sort of like natural glam that I love to do for like pictures and just like going out, or just like things that don't require like a full beat, but I want to look, you know, glowy and glam at the same time. As always, I will leave everything like listed down below if you guys want to remember shade names or like products or anything like that. But I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. I feel like it was a really requested video from you guys after I did like my full beat heavy glam look to do something like a little bit more natural and wearable. So I really hope you guys loved it. The day I'm posting this, I can't believe Christmas is in 10 days time. I'll have a couple videos going up. Well, definitely at least one more video going up before Christmas. I'll try and get another couple. Shout me some suggestions. I'm gonna film like a Christmas glow up. I've got a few like beauty appointments in the next couple of days that I'm gonna film. So we've got that to look forward to. But let me know like what other video do you wanna see like before Christmas? Let me know in the comment section. And also don't forget to let me know Charlotte Tilbury dupes. Let's help each other out. Let's find some dupes for these amazing products that like are always out of stock. I've tried my best to list as many that I can that are in stock. But I love you guys, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.